Hello there, and welcome to another episode of .NET MAUI 101, where we're going to talk about how to make differences in your UI based on the type of device, the idiom that you're running on. Hey, hey, and welcome back to another episode of .NET MAUI 101, where we're going to talk about an idiom, which makes it possible for you to make differences in your UI, different decisions basically, based on the type of device that you're running on. So based on if you're running on a phone or a desktop or a tablet, or maybe it's unknown, you can make different decisions for your layout in XAML and have your layout show up a little bit differently. So let's have a look how to implement that. Here in Visual Studio, I have created a new .NET MAUI project, and I've implemented a couple of places where we can see how the on idiom could work in your project. So let's just have a look. Let's start with this label where maybe you want to have a different text color. It doesn't sound very realistic, but it's just to make a point, a different text color based on the idiom that you're running on. So let me just uncomment this. If you've never seen this before, this is also a way how you can set properties in XAML. So you can't just set it with these attributes, but you can also do it kind of like this, more the HTML style, I would say. So here you can just do this. And now for the text color, we can say, hey, on idiom, you have to specify the type argument so it knows that we're dealing with a color here. So just it gets cast correctly by the XAML parsing engine. And here you can say, hey, we have a default one. And here we have a phone, which is red. So if you go here, we have like the different options. So default, desktop, phone, tablet, TV, watch, we have all these options here. But like this, with the default, we can say, hey, typically it's blue, but whenever we're running on a phone, it's red. And I can add the rest, right? If we're running on a watch, then it's going to be yellow, right? So you can specify all these options, but if you don't specify options, you can do it like this with the default and then make an exception for just one idiom. So if I run this on Windows, which will be the default, so it's going to be this blue color, right? Because we're running on a desktop and I didn't specify it, but I did specify this default option. So we should see that our Hello World label is going to be blue. And here we go. It might not show up on your screen really nicely, but this definitely is blue. So we have that. And now if I switch over to Android, so let me just switch over to the Android emulator here, and I run it on that, which is the idiom phone, obviously, is going to be red. Well, it's not obviously. Android can also be a tablet, right? So it's dependent on the device, not on the OS. And it's going to show, because this is a phone emulator, so it's going to show this label in red. There we go. It's a red label. So we have that. Okay, this is one way. It's a bit verbose, right? A lot of XAML, which not always everyone's cup of tea. So let's just click this one away and let's see how we can do it else. So you can also do it with like this XAML type converter. So type converters, there's a lot of them built into .NET MAUI, and they also were for XAML forms and other XAML based languages. And here, let's say we want to do a different image based on the idiom. So we have this image source, and what you can say here is inside of this attribute. So not, you can also write this the exact same way as the label. We could not make this image self-closing. We can do it here and we can say, hey, image.source, and we could do the same thing, right? So this is basically the same, but written a little bit different. And here in this source, we can just use this type converter. So I'm going to paste this in. And here you have this curly brace that always indicates usually that you're going to use this type converter. And then we have on idiom. And now we can specify this one. So we have this .NET bot. Again, if you leave out this field right here, it's going to assume this is the default. So you could also write it like this if that's what you want. So we have this default. It's going to be .NET bot. And then you can do comma, and then you can say, hey, desktop is, and we are going to run on Windows because Windows is a desktop one. We can also do comma phone. So we now have this different for desktop and phones. So again, if I run this now on Android, we're going to see this .NET bot holding a little Android bot. And if I were to run the same thing on desktop, then we're going to see the Microsoft logo because to kind of indicate that we're running on Windows, right? So we have little Android bot right here. We stop this one and we switch over to Windows and we go to Windows. And now we should see a different bot. And if I were to run, I'm not going to show you this right now, but if I were to run on a tablet, then you would see the regular .NET bot, right? So there would be no difference there. So now here is coming up on Windows and you can see that we have a different little logo right here. So you can also write it like this if that's what you prefer, but we can take it even a step further. We could do it in styles. So I also have a video on styles that should pop up on your screen right now. But with styles, you can do the same thing. So here, do this content page.resources. You can also do the resources in a little different file or on another level. all explained in the other video. But here we can do this style for a target type button. We can do a setter, and that's how we specify the property that we're going to style. And we can say on idiom here again, we have to specify the same X type arguments. It's the same syntax as the one that I showed you first. And then we can say, hey, default and desktop. But now we can just have this target type button, and it's going to apply to this button automatically. So let me just show you really quickly. If I run this on Windows, we're going to have a red background color for the button because I specified the desktop specifically and the other one is default. So all the other idioms, the phone, the tablet, the watch, is going to have a yellow background color. See, so it also picks up from the styles. Now, this is all very much focused on XAML because this has very much to do with like, hey, how the layout looks and feels. But you can, of course, also make differences based on code. So if we go to the code behind of this main page, then now here we have this device info APIs, and we can say dot idiom. This is a property on the device info APIs, and we can see if the device idiom is desktop, or we have all the other ones here as well. Desktop, phone, tablet, TV, unknown, and watch, right? So we can make decisions based on that. And whenever we're running on a desktop, we're going to do plus is 10, and else we're just going to do plus plus. And that is how you make differences in your application based on the device type. Another basic principle of .NET MAUI has now been learned. You're on your way to becoming a .NET MAUI master, but did you also know that you have compiled bindings which will make the performance of your .NET MAUI app better? I've got a video for you right here. See you on that one.